Okay, give me some Hennessy. Listen to some R&B Christmas music. Listen, I'm ready.
Hey love, welcome back to my channel. This is Kiss and Makeup here. I'm coming to you guys today with my second week of Christmas. If you have not seen my first week of Christmas, please head over to my channel and check that video out. It is Grinch inspired, so it's a lot of greens going on. But I don't know if you can tell what my intentions were for this video. Just by the look, I'm gonna give you a second. If you don't know, the look is inspired by Let It Snow. I'm not sure if you guys really realize it, but whenever you go into a store that's selling like Christmas decorations, 9 out of 10, that Let It Snow sign or pillow or whatever is normally blue, white, and silver. So I was like, well, Angel, you know, you dark skin, so, you know, a lot of blues. I was kind of afraid to play in blues just because I was a little bit darker. I didn't want it to come out like clownish. But it actually came out pretty damn good, and this video will be a I don't know why I just said it like that. This video will be a talk through and actually a beginner friendly to a cut crease. So I actually figured out how to do my cut crease on accident. If you watched my last Grinch video, that's where I kind of realized what I was doing pretty much, because the way I'm going to show you is basically foolproof. There's no way for you to mess this shit up. Like, literally, there's no way for you to mess it up. So, I'm going to put that in too. Again, it's going to be a talk through. So, let's get started. Eyeliner, but not like pencil eyeliner, like not like this is my eyebrow pencil, but not like an actual pencil liner. I'm not sure if this will work. I've never tried it. I don't know how blendable it would be. I would assume it would be, but I mean like roll up liners. This is the one that I actually used in my other video. It had like a shimmer to it, like a crayon type liner, because they blend out so easily. I got another one too, this red one. They blend out extremely easy. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to line my crease pretty much. So I'm going to take this liner right all the way, and well, I'm going to show you what I'm going to do. Hold on. So starting at your inner corner. You can look down, it might be a little bit easier. Be careful not to press too hard. I do that all the time with my liners, and they go so quick because I'm so heavy-handed. I'm coming here, and I'm gonna make a V. Again, if it was sharper, it'd probably be a lot easier than what I'm doing, but so pretty much like that. That liner out. And we're gonna do this a couple times just to make sure that it's blended out. And you wanna blend up pretty much, not down. Y'all don't even wanna know how long it took me to get to this point. Like, for some reason it was so hard, and I feel like I'm very,
artsy. Like, I know how to draw to an extent. But it was just so hard for me. Like, it was really, really hard. So this made me super happy. This is probably one of the main reasons why I started my YouTube, was to see my growth and stuff like this. So it makes me happy. And then we want to definitely come to the end and blend that out, because you don't want it to be a line. This line right here doesn't really matter, because as you can see, my eyeliner is going to cover it. So that can actually be, you can actually use that as a guide for your eyeliner if you need it. So with that being down, I am now going to go in with, this is just a lip pencil. It's called For Your Beauty. I think I got it from like Rossmann's, which is like a drugstore here, pretty sure. And to start off, I found like a thicker consistency of concealer, because I can control it a little bit better versus it being like an LA girl. I feel like an LA girl is too messy, it's too wet, so I feel like it'll transfer easier. So this is Catrice Cosmetics. I got this from here too. They have this really, really light shade that I'm going to use, but I'm going to mix that in with my Ruby Kisses palette, and they're like, it's almost like a white kind of color shade. And I'm going to go in with a stiffer. This is actually pretty stiff too, or really thick, probably would be the better term. But I don't know, for me, I just feel like it's easier to control it being stiffer. I do have to work a little bit faster, but it is a lot easier to control. Okay, so I get a decent amount, not a lot. I don't work with a lot either, because that'll mess you up too. Decent amount on the brush, and let's see if I can do this on camera, y'all. I always start by my lash line. I don't know why. I just work up with what's product. I work the product up versus working the product down, because then I can kind of make my line straighter. So if I was started up here, I got a lot more product on this brush up here that I have to kind of move around and work around or work with, versus if I started at the bottom, I could like push the product up and then make my line. Hopefully that makes sense, y'all. So and I try to keep my eye almost closed so it doesn't transfer up. But this concealer is so thick, it probably wouldn't. What's going to actually intensify my line is when I go in for my shadows. That's what's going to do it for me. So my shadows are always just like a flat shadow brush. It's not necessarily a dome, because it's more wide than anything, but I use one of these and I wet them to intensify my shadow. But out here, it's going to be a darker color. I'm going to go out here with just the blue, the regular blue that I used, to blend that out too. So now I'm going to go ahead and do my liner and stuff, and I'll be right back. Alright, y'all. So I went ahead and finished my other eye. I had a battle a little bit with my eyeliner. You know how I go, one get bigger, then the other one gotta get bigger. And so my eyeliner is a little bit thicker than I would like, but I show you guys. So I'm just going right in my waterline with black. All right, guys, so this is the final look. It turned out bomb, y'all. Earlier, I did have to go back and fix this eye because I did do this eye for camera, so I wasn't really, like, I didn't have to look in two places. But this eye, I kind of messed up a little bit, but it was an easy fix. If you are planning to do a look similar, no, my eyelash is killing me. And if you are intending to do a look similar or try the little tip that I put in my video, you can fix it. Versus, I'm not really sure about a regular cut crease because I've never really like done it successfully, but I know this one you can fix. You just make the line over again. That's what all I had to do. So it was an easy fix. I did have on a new lip at first, but I was like, listen, y'all know, I was like, girl, you need to put on a blue lip. And so I went and found my blue lip. I wish I would have had something a little bit lighter, but it's really cute. I decided to be a little festive. I ain't supposed to see all that. I decided to be a little bit festive and pull out something glittery and sparkly. I wish I would have had a background for this occasion, but I don't. They're in the mail. They're not here yet. But I did find some lights. We only had red though, so. But I had a lot of fun making this look. Please comment below. Like, let me know what you think about the look. Let me know what you'd like to see. So definitely share and subscribe. And meet me back here. Right here. Not at this time though, because I'd be a little lazy. But right here for my final week of the Christmas countdown for Makeup Monday. I know I want it to be red. I'm just kind of playing around in my head as to what I want to be red. I'm normally a red lip type of girl. But who knows? But thanks for watching, you guys. I'm going to insert some pictures so you can see them because I'm feeling myself for real. But yeah, thanks for watching.